Hi there, a very warm welcome to Hackanons. In this tutorial, I will show you how to repair, install or restore Grub bootloader with the help of Ubuntu or a Kali Live CD. So guys, let's get started. Typically, Grub gets overridden when you install Windows or another operating system, and some other reasons include adding a or removing a hard drive or changing a hard drive partition settings. So guys, you might familiar with these problems, like here Grub menu dot not detecting Windows or other operating system, you are getting a Grub rescue, or there is no Grub menu detection, means there is no Grub menu directly Windows bootloader is starting. So guys, in this tutorial we will see how to resolve all these three problems. All these three problems require same restoring steps. So guys, now let's see how to resolve them. First step, you have to create a bootable pen drive of any Linux ISO to whom you want to repair. And guys, here we are, if you can see here, we are creating a Kali Linux bootable ISO using Win32 disk imager. And if you don't know how to create a bootable ISO, you can check my previous tutorial on how to create a bootable ISO using Win32 disk imager. So guys, now after creating a bootable ISO, you just have to plug it and select live from USB in BIOS mode. And after selecting, then what you have to do is, you can see this type of a screen, and after that you have to select open live CD from your ISO. As you can see, here is a Kali live CD. Here I am selecting this, and guys, after that it will take some time, about 2 to 3 minutes. Or it might take about 4 minutes according to your PC configuration. Your files will get loaded, and you can see a live system. In live system, all the files will not save. The work you have to do, all the work that you will do will not save. And after that, you have to open your terminal and let's see. So guys, after opening the terminal, you have to type blkid. Blkid will show the IDs of all the hard disk partitions present in your hard disk. Here you have to search for the partition which is of type ext4 and in which your Ubuntu or Kali Linux is installed. So guys, here I am having SDA7, and after that you have to mount it. For mounting, you have to type mount space backslash dev then SDA, and here you have to type SDA7, SDA1, SDA3 according to your partition, then mount it. After that you have to type mount sudo mount then space dash dash bind, and then you have to type space dev then space, and after that you have to type mount mnt, sorry. And guys, all the commands are written in the description, you can check from there. Mnt and then backslash dev, after that space, and then you have to type end. Guys, end will help to type 1, 2, 3 commands at a time, then press enter. And as you press enter, then there will be an option to type other commands, and then you have to bind the proc command proc. And for binding the proc, you have to type sudo mount bind dev pts, sorry, before proc you have to bind pts. And for pts, same as dev, after dev you have to type pts and then mount dev pts at the end. Here I am typing mount and then dev. And yes guys, now after that I have to bind proc as I say previously, sudo mount dash dash bind then space proc then space mnt and then proc proc. And guys, then after proc you have to type bind sys and space mnt. And guys, you can, as I am using spacebar for shorten the command, you can also use spacebar. And after that mount sys and end, sorry, mount sys and then press enter. Then in the sys you don't have to write end, you can directly copy paste from description as I said previously. And after mounting sys, then you have to type sudo chroot mount. This will convert you in a root user. It will take some time, but it will work. I think it will take a delay of 10 to 20 seconds, this command, as it is taking delay, you can see here. After that you have to type grub install, and here you have to type dev sd, don't type dev sd 7 6 4 because I previously tried it, it will not work. You have to type on simple dev sda, and yeah, I'm typing dev and then sda. Yes guys, now after it will install the grub in your hard disk. After that it will take some time, and after that you have to recheck it that whether it is whether the grub installed or not. For that we will check another command. Here we will check it by using, so after that you have to type update grub, and for updating a grub you have to use update slash grub. And guys, please don't worry, copy the command from line by line from description and do them, all the process is same. And after updating the grub, then you have to again install the grub and recheck it. Guys, it's optional. If you don't want, then there is no need to re-again installing, but re-again install will help you to check whether the grub is installed or not. So now I will again install the grub and recheck it, and after that I will get exit. I will using previous command. So guys, now I'm again installing the grub using grub install dev sda, and it is taking some time. Yes guys, now my grub has been installed. Now I will type grub install hyphen double hyphen recheck and then space dev sda. And guys, please mind the space, directly copy paste them from description. Guys, for copy pasting, then what you can do is you can open the live CD and then connect it through internet, and you can open the my video description and copy paste them into the terminal. And for copy pasting you can use Ctrl Shift C, because Ctrl C will not work. And now my grub has been rechecked, and now you can see here it is showing sector 2 is already used by program. It is showing because I have already previous typed the command, because as I said, the last two commands are optional. It's your choice. Yeah, you will want, and after you have type exit and end. Now our grub has been installed. Now we will unmount all the partitions that we have previously mounted. For unmounting, we will unmount it in the back order. Now here we will unmount first of all sys. So for unmounting, type sudo unmount then mount sys and again then type unmount mount proc for unmounting the proc. Sudo unmount proc and for unmounting the proc, then unmount the pts, sudo unmount space mint dev pts. Use up arrow key for getting the previous commands. Yeah, as I take here, and then and after that we have to unmount the dev. Now I have unmounted the dev. After that you have to unmount the mount, sudo unmount backslash mnt, and at last you have to exit. For exiting, you can use the command direct exit, and after exit directly so guys, now I have got exit. Now you can press init0 or init6. init0 will shut down, and init6 will restart the computer. So guys, now after exiting, our grub has been successfully installed. Now you can restart it, and after restarting I will show you my grub has been successfully installed. I will get the windows in my grub menu. Here I am restarting. Actually the quality is a bit low because of the, so now you can see here I'm getting a Windows 10 and Kali Linux both. So in first I will open the Kali Linux. You can see Kali Linux is opening fine, and after the Kali Linux I will show you how is my Windows opening on. You can see here my Kali Linux is opening on dev sda7, because we have selected dev sda7 before in the terminal. So guys, now you can see my Kali Linux is loading fine. And guys, all the commands are same for Ubuntu, Linux, Mint and other systems that are based on Debian or Ubuntu. And now I will show you the Windows, whether my Windows is working or not. Guys, these all commands are fully tested, working 100% fine. I have tried it on 10 to 15 times before giving you this tutorial. So now you can see my Kali Linux is login screen has been successfully there. Now I will show you for Windows. So now I have restarted my system again, Control Alt D, and you can see now you can see I will select Windows here, and I will show you that my Windows is also loading from Grub. Okay, actually this problem arises because I installed Windows over Ubuntu. That's why Windows bootloader flushed my Grub, and I restarted the Grub again. So now you can see my Windows is starting again. So now you can see my Windows is loading. So that's it for this tutorial, guys. In this tutorial we will successfully see how to reinstall or restore Grub. So thanks for watching. If you like my tutorial, please don't forget to give a like and subscribe. Bye bye, have a nice day.